Today topic is GL master creation. Today topic is GL master creation. Hi John, are you able to hear my voice?
Yeah, very well.
Yeah, very good. Everyone, please follow. Today topic is GL master creation. First of all, you people understand what is meant by master data creation. What is meant by master data? You just understand here. I will tell you one example. In the SAP, as a functional consultant, as a functional guys, we have three types of data. Listen carefully. What is three types of data? One is configuration data. Number two is master data. And transactional data, configurational data, master data, and transactional data. What is meant by configurational data? So from the see here, whatever activity you do in the SPRO screen. That activity is called configurational data. For example, since first class we do n number of activities in the SPRO screen. Example, enterprise structure, SPRO screen, global parameters, SPRO screen, document splitting, SPRO screen, parallel accounting, SPRO screen. All the activities we did in the SPRO screen. So that activities saved as a configurational data. Okay. Then what is meant by master data? After completion of configurational data, now we need to create master data. What is meant by master data? Master data in the sense, where you want to do this master data? SAP Easy Access screen. What is meant by master data? Means to create the GLs. Example, to create the GLs and to create the vendors. And to create the customers and to create the assets, like that. This is called master data. All the configuration linked to master data. Whatever configuration you do in the SPRO screen, that configurational data, it's going to link master data and transactional data. Okay, whatever SPRO screen is the back end. SAP Easy Access screen is a front end. Okay, for example, see here. We have already in the demo class, I already explained. We have in the R by 3 means we have three types of layers. One is presentation layer. And application layer and database layer. So what is meant by presentation layer? Presentation layer nothing but SAP Easy Access screen. And what is meant by application layer? Application layer means like a technical consultant, I mean ABAPer, write the program, and functional consultant do the SPRO screen activity. Okay, And database layer means, database layer means the basis consultant maintain the database. All the information saved in one place. Server, nothing but server. SAP basis people maintain this database layer. Once again, you can listen careful. We have three types of data available in the SAP. One is configurational data, master data, and transactional data. So what is meant by configurational data? Whatever activity you do in the SPRO screen, that activity is called configurational data. And what is meant by master data? And whatever activity you do in the, whatever activity you do in the SAP easy access screen, that to create the GL, create the vendor, create the customer, create the vendors, this type of activities is called master data. And what is meant by transactional data? Transactional data means document entry posting. Document entry posting. What is meant by transactional data? Transactional data nothing but document entry posting. Where you do this activity? This activity will do like, this activity will do SAP easy access screen. Master data you do SAP easy access screen. Transactional data you do SAP easy access screen. So this two activities is called presentation layer. And SPRO activity nothing but application layer. This application used for the ABAPR will write the program, and functional consultant will use for the configuration, like configuration. And what is meant by database layer? Database layer nothing but like in the basis consultant used for the maintained from the database, nothing but server. Basis consultant will take care of this. Anyone, any doubts here? If you are okay, we can go move.
Okay, sir, no doubts.
Yeah, okay, sir.
Oh, yeah, thank you everyone. Yeah, now I am able to create the GLs. Now I am able to create the GL. Everyone, please understand carefully master data creation and accounting entry postings or transactional data posting. Master data creation and transactional data posting. Why? Because all the configurational data linked to master data creation and transactional data posting. Master data means GL creation, vendor creation, customer creation, and asset creation. Transactional data means document entry posting or accounting entry posting is called like transactional data. All the configurational data linked to master data, transactional data. You please understand up to first class. Why we did, now you can understand. Okay, and now I am able to create the GLs. Go to create the GL. See here, create GL master. Example, I want to create cash account. How to create cash account? Under which GL I need to create cash account? And example, do one thing. I want to create admin expenses. Before going to cash, I will tell you one thing. I want to create admin expenses. Admin expenses comes under indirect expenses. Admin expenses comes under indirect expenses. Is this correct or not? This admin expenses comes under indirect expenses. Let's open SAP. Under SAP, Anji, you just catch here. I think you previously you asked me one question, how to check accounts group. Okay, this indirect expenses is the accounts group. In this indirect expenses, which number range I maintained, you please check it out, then create the GL. Okay, I want to create admin expenses. Admin expenses comes under indirect expenses. So which number I need to take? So that is my task. Okay, and that's the reason. Go to OBD4. Go to OBD4. Enter T code OBD4. Enter and click on your position. Enter your chart of accounts. What is our chart of accounts?
GMOC.
Very good. GMOC. Press enter. Here I maintain our accounts group. Where is indirect expenses? See here. This is our chart of accounts. Accounts group. Description. From number to number. Means whatever indirect GLs you want to create, you need to create under this number range. For example, when I create the rent, comes under indirect expenses. When I create salaries, comes under indirect expenses. You need to take this number to this number. Any number you need to take. This number to this number. Okay. Example, admin expenses. Admin expenses. 4400. Here, what, which number will come? 4400000. This is the one, right? 4400000 to 4499999. This number will come. Okay, let's create the GL. Admin expenses I want to create. How to create the GL? What is the path? SAP menu. Don't go to SPRO screen. This is comes under SAP menu, SAP easy access screen. SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master data, GL accounts. Okay, FS00, very popular T code is this. FS00 is create the GL accounts. So go to SAP, SAP easy access screen, SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master data, GL accounts, individual, create centrally, FS00. Once again, you just listen. SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master records, GL accounts, individual processing, then centrally. Double click on here. See here, it's asked. First you need to enter the number. What is the number? 4400000. Why I want to enter this number? This is comes under indirect expenses. 4400000. And enter your company code GM10. Then click on your create. Accounts group comes under indirect expenses. This indirect expenses comes under profit and loss account or balance sheet?
Profit and loss account.
So select your profit and loss account. So this this here you can write the name admin expenses. Admin expenses account and admin expenses account. And this admin expenses account comes under which department, functional area? At the time of enterprise structure configuration, we created functional area. You people remember? And here you need to select which functional area. this administration expenses comes under which functional area? Regarding, I created some of the functional areas. See this one? This is the one, right? GM, right? See this one. GM admin department. GM admin department, GM contract department, GM functional department, like this. So this is comes under GM admin department functional area. GM admin department. So this is the admin expenses comes under admin department. Where I created this functional area? At the time of enterprise structure, I created this functional area. Okay, then click on here, control tab, see here. Even some years back, I attended Capgemini interview. The interviewer asked the question, at the time of FS00 creation, which tabs is available? Which tabs is available? There is an a types of description, control tab, create bank interest. This three tabs is very important, and keywords transaction and information, this is the optional. These tabs will automatically updated based on these three things. So you need to tell these five tabs in the interview. Okay, and click on your control tab. Yeah, what is mean by account currency? What is mean by account currency? Very important. Every point is very important. What is mean by account currency? Do one thing, concentrate here. Which currency I automatically picked? Example, at center INR. Concentrate here. Concentrate here. I will tell you one example. And company code currency. What is my company code currency?
INR, sir.
Very good. My company code currency is INR, right? It's called local currency. Very good. My company code currency is INR. At the time of GL creation, whatever currency you are specified, at the time of GL creation, whatever currency you are specified into this field, that is called account currency. Example, account currency. Example, let us take account currency. Why I want to maintain account currency? Everyone, you just catch the point. If my account currency is maintained INR, this GL, whatever GL, example admin expenses, if my admin expenses GL account currency is INR, admin expenses GL now able to post any currency. You everyone catch the point. My company code currency and account currency, if both are same, that type of GL is able to post any currency. Okay, and in case if I entered USD or Euro, USD or EUR, right?
EUR, sir.
EUR. My account currency maintain EUR, what happened? If my account currency is maintain EUR, what happened means this is the GL, this is 444000 GL. I am able to post only Euro currency. I am unable to post other currencies. Got it my point? If my company code currency, my account currency is both are same, the GL will allow all the currency accounting entry posting. if my company code currency and my account currency may be differ, example USD, what happened? That type of GL allows only USD, only account currency, or only EUR, whatever EUR. EUR, whatever currency you are specified into this field, that currency only allowed at the time of accounting entry posting. Note it down. Heading is account currency. Understood? Sunil, are you understand?
Yes, sir.
Understood, right? Note it down. Heading is example account currency.
Sir, type and description tab, one field is missing now, sir.
Which field? Are every field I will explain you later. First, what I am telling you, you can understand that information. Every field will come.
Retained earnings, sir. Retained earning account field is missing now, sir.
Retained earning account field not in ECC. That is an S/4HANA.
Okay.
Everyone, my concern is I'm not skip any subject. You just based on your understanding, I will explain. I mean, based on which field is required, that fields I will explain. So based on the situation, I will explain you all the fields. Don't bother. One second.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Based on the, I mean, situation, I will explain you all the fields. Don't fear. Note it down. Account currency.
Okay, sir.
What is meant by account currency? Account currency. One second. Account currency means account. Note it down. Account currency means. It is GL currency. Account currency means it is GL currency. Note it down. If my company code currency if my company code currency and account currency is same, if my company code currency and account currency is same, that time my GL will allow all the currency accounting entry postings. If my company code currency, account currency is same, example this is INR and this is also INR, what happened? That time my GL will allow to post all the currencies, to post accounting entries all the currencies. Done. Next line, note it down. Next line, if my company code currency and my account currency may differ, if my company code currency and my account currency may be differ. Maybe differ. That time, GL will allow to post only account currency. It cannot allow all the currencies. That time, GL will allow to post only account currency. Whatever you maintained in the account currency, that currency will only allowed. Other currencies not allowed to post accounting entries. Done?
Yes.
Rajkumar, done? Understand what is meant by that?
Done, Venkat.
Yeah. Understood?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah. And these fields I will go down. And what is mean? Click on your line item display. Click on your line item display. What is meant by line item display? Harish, are you there?
Yeah, sir.
This line item display field in the ECC available. S/4HANA not available. Why they're not available means that is S/4HANA. Okay?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, this example, this line item field not in S/4HANA. Okay? So you please concentrate first yes, ECC. And line item field available only in the ECC, not S/4HANA. Okay, some radio buttons is different. That is different things. You can understand ECC. Okay, line item display.
Okay.
Line item display. What is meant by line item display? Everyone, note it down. Put the heading of line item display. Before going to give the notes, I will explain you one thing. For example.
Sir, we cannot hear your voice, sir.
Now, how is now? Everyone, John, are able to hear my voice? Before understanding line item display, you need to understand short key. So what is meant by short key? Short key is screen layout of assignment field. So where is that assignment field? Assignment field at the time of accounting entry posting in the line item, there is a one field. Field is called assignment field. Example, in the short key, posting date or document date. Example, posting date, document date, document number and fiscal year. Example, I taken posting date. What happened? In the assignment field, at the time of accounting entry posting, automatically this posting date will be updated. When I select your document date, what happened? So that assignment field automatically updated document date. Okay, note it down, short key. Got it my point? John, understood?
Yeah, understood, yeah.
Very good, note it down, short key. short key. Short key is, short key is short key is screen layout of assignment field. Screen layout of assignment field. Screen layout of assignment field. So next line you can write it down. Based on screen, I mean based on short key parameters, based on short key parameters, this is the parameters, based on short key parameters, assignment field automatically updated. Assignment field automatically updated. Assignment field automatically updated. Next line you can note it down. Next line, assignment field at, assignment field at available, assignment field at available. At the time of accounting entry posting, at the time of accounting entry posting, in line item, in line item. Done, completed.
Yes, Venkat, noted.
Yes.
And next, click on your line item display. Note, put the heading of line item. What is meant by line item and all? Every radio button is very, very important. Interviewer will ask anywhere. Sometimes they will ask what is meant by account currency. What is meant by line item display? See, for example, when I tell the class, later you need to browse the Google. Later you need to contact with your seniors. Later you can read your some books. Then you can attend the interview. Okay? And kana, pina, sona, this is not a good way to get the job. Okay? Do some hard work. Okay? And click on here line item display. No, what is meant by line item display? I will tell you later. Do one thing. Example. I will give you one example. What is meant by line item display? For example, fiscal year variant or financial year variant. For example, if you are financial statements, if you are in financial statement, what is meant by financial statement? Balance sheet and profit and loss account, and balance sheet and profit and loss account. There some value should be updated. When you double click on that value, this value will goes to like accounting entry postings. Accounting entry postings. Okay, and when I double click on this accounting entry posting, this will goes to and master data. This will go to master data. Master data. So this is one line item. This is one line item. So if you are in the financial statement, the value should be updated. When you double click on that values, it will be reflected that value belongs to which accounting entry postings. Accounting and which accounting entry postings. When I double click on this accounting entries, this accounting entry belongs to which master data. Like there is a one sequence, one line. There is a one sequence. There is a one line. So if you want to see this sequence, you want to click line item display. Note it down. What is meant by line item display? Note it down. If you set the line item display, if you set line item display, if you set the line item display indicator, if you set line item display indicator, in the master data records, in the master data records, so what need to understand this point means this line item display indicate, listen here. So what is meant by this, what you wrote, means this line item display indicator you need to activate at the time of master data creation. GL creation is the master data creation. So that time you need to activate line item display. Okay, and note it. Next point you can note it down. All the line items all the line items that have been posted, all the line items that have been posted all the line items that have been posted posted to TO2 to this accounts are displayed, to this account are displayed, accounts are displayed. Very simple. For example, if you want to understand what is meant by line item, you know, I explained easy manner. Any field, if you want to understand, very simple. Once you just click on that field and click on your F1, when you click on your F1, lot of data will come. You just read once. See, you can just read once what is meant by line item and all. Very simple. If you want to understand any field, first you can click on that field and click on your F1 in the keyboard. Press F1 in the keyboard. Hare Krishna. Line item. Click, press F1. Hare, what happened? See, line item. See, this is the line item enable to line item. This is explained what is meant by line item and all. Once you can read based on my things, okay? Yeah, and click on your line item, click on your line item, enter short key and go to create bank interest app. Go to create bank interest app, field status group. You people remember, at the time of global parameters I explained field status variant. Here, define field status variant in the global parameters. Please remind my previous classes. So here you need to select field status group. Example G001. So once again, you people understand, enter your GL number, and this GL number comes under admin expenses. This admin expenses comes under indirect expenses. This admin expenses comes under which department? And control data, let's take account currency INR and go down, line item display, short key 001, and create bank interest app G001. Click on your save. Remaining fields I will explain based on the situation. Now this fields is required, enter these fields and click on your save. See this one, data was saved. Array, note, write the note in down, write the note. Note, if you do any activity, in the SAP Easy Access screen, TR will not generated. Example, when you create master data and post accounting entries. If you post accounting entries, TR will not generate. What is meant by TR, I already explained. Don't write that word, okay? Done. And create one more GL. Example, let it be. I want to create salary account. So what is meant by salary account? This salary account comes under indirect expenses. This salary account create, everyone, you just catch the point. This salary account create indirect expenses. So what is the number range for indirect expenses? In the Excel I already maintain. What is the indirect expenses? See here.
Double four, double zero.
Oh, very good, very good. I'm showing. Very good. See this one? Yeah. Hare Krishna. See this one? 4400002 4499999. So, and create the GL means SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master record, GL accounts, individual, create. And enter here 44000 already maintained, and click on here 1. 44001. Enter your company code, click on your create, and select your indirect expenses, select your profit and loss account, and functional area comes under which department? This is comes under GM finance department. Salaries comes under GM finance department, and let this is comes under profit and loss account. Select your profit and loss account and write the description. What is the description? Salaries account. Then click on your control data and account currency INR, go down, line item display, short key 001, example, create bank interest of G001, press enter and save. See this one, when I click on save, no TR will be generated here. Okay, master data creation, accounting entry postings, no TR will generate. Okay, then one more GL, this one is completed. One more GL, equity share capital account. Example, I want to create Ramesh Capital. I want to create Ramesh Capital GL account. Ramesh Capital GL account. So this is 44001. You people understand? Admin expenses 44000. Salary account 44001. If you create any indirect expenses 02, 03, like that. Okay. And I want to create Ramesh Capital. This Ramesh Capital comes under share capital group. Share capital. What is the share capital accounts number? And slash n. Otherwise, click on your new window. Go to OBD4, enter. And click on your position. Enter here your chart of accounts. What is our chart of accounts? GMOC, enter. Where is share capital? You just find out where is share capital we created. See here, share capital. What is the number range? 100002109999. This is number range I entered for share capital. So I want to create Ramesh Capital. Comes under share capital. Which number range will come? 100000 will come. Okay, and go to FS00 and enter here 100000. Enter your company code GM10. Click on your create. Accounts group, share capital. Where is share capital? Select your share capital. This share capital comes under profit and loss account or balance sheet?
Balance sheet.
Oh, very good. Very good. Click on your balance sheet and write the description. What is the short name and full name? Ramesh Capital. Enter your Ramesh Capital account and Ramesh Capital account. Okay, then click on your control data, account currency, go down, line item display, example short key 001, any short key. Okay, create bank interest of G001, press enter and save. Press enter and save. Okay, and one more things. The last one, I need to create one more GL cash account. One more GL I want to create cash account. And which accounts group comes under cash and bank accounts group? And go to, for example, go to OBD4. Otherwise, go to this Excel already explained. Once again, I will show you where this number range I maintained here. Let us see here, OBD4. This is the path. This is the path. Okay, this is the path. OBD4 T code. And go to OBD4. For your understanding, I am showing all the screens. Go to OBD4, press enter and click on your position. Enter here your chart of accounts. GMOC. See your first one. Cash and bank. 2200002 2299999. So which number comes here? 2200000 will comes. Okay, and go to SAP, enter here. For your understanding, and go back and enter your T code FS00, enter the number 2200000, enter the company code, click on create, and this cash account comes which group? Cash and bank. This cash and bank comes under profit and loss account and balance sheet.
Balance sheet.
Very good. Balance sheet. And select your balance sheet and select your cash account and paste it here. Cash account and cash account, and go to create control data, account currency, go down, line item display, short key 001, create bank interest tab, G001, here note it down. What is this? Relevant to cash flow. Everyone, you just catch the point here. All the banks related GLs, all the cash related GLs, you must select radio button relevant to cash flow. Why? Because all the banks GLs, cash GL, control the cash flow. That is the reason. At the time of cash related GLs, at the time of bank related GL creation, you need to select relevant to cash flow. Got it my point? Previously I created salary account, share capital account. That time you don't want to select relevant to cash flow. Only cash GL creation, bank's GL's creation, that time you need to select relevant to cash flow. Why? Because it is monitoring the cash flow. Okay, select here cash flow, then click on here save. Done. So this is created. So where you want to create GL accounts, the T code is FS00. The next one, what is meant by change GL master data? Change GL master data. Example, let's take example, change GL master data. Basically, this is called Suresh Capital. By mistakenly I entered Ramesh Capital, so I need to change the description, right? Instead of Ramesh Capital, I need to enter Suresh Capital. basically this is Suresh Capital. By mistakenly I entered Ramesh Capital. So I need to change the description. So how to, this is the one, change GL master. How to change GL master? FS00. So go to FS00, go to FS00, enter. So what is this number? 10000, 10000. Copy this number, enter here 10000, 10000. See here, what is this? Change. When you want to create new GL, click on here create. When you want to change old GL, click on here change. So here Ramesh Capital, right? Ramesh Capital, you need to change Suresh Capital. Suresh Capital. Suresh Capital. I changed Ramesh Capital to Suresh Capital. If you want to change anything, you can change. Change. Then click on your save. Write it down one note. Note click on. John, write one note.
Yeah. Okay.
Before accounting entry posting, before accounting entry post, system will allow all the master data fields changes. Next line, you can write next line. If you post accounting entry, system will not allow to change. All the master data fields. Even note it down. Even after accounting entry postings, system will allow some fields able to change. Example description, text. Example description and text. Done.
Venkat, I have doubt here.
Chapandi. Naveen, please go ahead.
So we have selected here company code as a GM10, right?
Yes.
So if we want, yes, we have created two company codes like GM10 and as well as GM20. For yes. GM20 also we have to use the same GL code, or we need to change the
number? We if you want to use same GL code to GM20, you need to extend GM10 to GM20. You need to extend. That is different topic. I will explain you later.
Okay.
If you want to use same code to GM20 also, you need to extend GM10 to GM20. Then you can use.
Okay.
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 Yeah.
So there are any extend, sorry.
Yeah, extend. You can extend.
GL code extend also there. Yes.
This GL code need to extend GM10 to GM20. Then you can use.
Okay,
Venkat, thanks.
Okay.
Sorry, Puna. That means following the question of Arish. That means that, for example, we have five company code. We do the same manner, extending from one company code to another company code, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Got it right? So what is meant by change master data? Change master data means if you post accounting entry, the system will not allow all the fields. Before accounting entry posting, the system will allow all the fields changes up in the master data. Okay, in the master data. Okay, then next one, display changes. For example, here I changed Ramesh capital to Suresh capital. If I changed Ramesh capital to Suresh capital, but display changes, FS, go to FS04/N, go back, enter here FS04, enter, and enter here account number. What is that account number? 10000. Yes, 10000, and enter your company code. Press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter, then click on your all changes. See here, I changed short text and long text. The old name is Ramesh capital, new name is Suresh capital. You just double click on any line item. See, this one here will display who changed and what time changed, user, SAP user changed, and what time, what is the date, everything will record it. Okay, in the real time, if you want to change anything, be careful. Okay, everything is going to record in the system. Very simple. So display changes means if you go to FS04, go to FS04, and which GL you need to check, enter your GL number and company code, press enter, then click on your all changes. Everyone are able to hear, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and the last one, this is the last one, how to block GL master data, unblock GL and block GL. Write it down, one note, you can write the note. As per the SAP suggestion, note it down. As per the SAP suggestions, uh, delete is not suggestible. Delete is not suggestible. Any objective, I'm saying all the objectives, as per the SAP, delete is not suggestible. Instead of delete, I'm using block and unblock. You can write like that. My question is, everyone are able to write the notes or not? One day I will all cameras, I will check everyone.
Yes, we are writing.
Yes,
yeah, we
are writing.
Yes. So
for me it's okay, sir. It's okay.
Okay. So what did you write? What did you write, John?
As for the SAP suggestion, delete is not suggestible.
Oh.
Instead of, yeah.
Renka, can you please go ahead? What did you write?
As per SAP suggestions, delete is not suggestible. Instead of delete, we can use block and unblock.
Very good, excellent. Instead of delete, John, you can write it down. Instead of delete, we can use block and unblock.
Yeah. That's okay, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, for example, I need to block admin expenses. I need to block admin expenses. I need to block admin expenses. Okay, how to block admin expenses? 44000 and go to FS00. Everyone, you just catch the point. Go to FS00, enter. Enter 44000 why? Because I need to block admin expenses. I need to block admin expenses. Enter here 44000. Then click on your display. This is create, this is change, and this is display. Okay. And go to menu bar. This is the menu bar. Go to menu bar. Click on your block. Click on your block. See this one? Block for creating, block for posting, block for planning, and block for postings. Then click on your save. So system will not allow to post any accounting entry of admin expenses. Then slash and go back. It is a blocked. So how to unblock? Same process. Go to FS00, enter here 44000 means which GL you want to unblock, enter here that number and click on your display and go to GL and click on your block again. You can remove these tick marks, then save. Data was saved. Okay, so this is the process of creating GL. In the future we will create more and more GLs. Okay, and example, this is some GL creation. Tomorrow I will start for accounting entry postings. Okay, example, how to post salary account data to cash and cash account data to Suresh Capital. How to post and all the accounting entries posting, we will take care of tomorrow. Thanks for joining. I'm signing out the class. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye,
everyone.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.